The otolith is the ear bone of the fish, and just like a tree, it lays down a ring every year so we can tell how old the fish is.
I don't know who discovered it was a good idea to age the ear bone, but whoever it was brilliant.
Our job is to provide, in partnership, independent data that Fisheries New Zealand use to make sustainability decisions.
Obtaining information on the age structure of the commercial fishery is crucial to successful stock assessments. If a stock is doing well and it's above its target, we could increase the catch. If the fish stock is down below the target, we might cut back, try and rebuild the stock to the target.
So it starts here, fish get unloaded. Then the fish will end up back in the sheds. Our staff or contractors will be in those fish sheds early in the morning, about 4 a.m, to meet those fish that we've selected from that landing. Then they'll measure them. A selection of them, they'll take the ear bones. We can use them back in the lab to age how old the fish are.
Okay, so an otolith is part of the structure in the ear. They mainly use it for balance. In order to be able to read the otolith, we need to get to the centre of the otolith so we can see the rings. As the fish grows, a layer of calcium carbonate will be laid down. The growth will speed up over summer and slow down over winter, so it leaves these really nice concentric bands. So what we're seeing here on this otolith is a 15 wide, which would equate to 16 years old.
So it takes about 10 minutes to prepare and age an otolith, and we collected about 17,000 otoliths last year. If you do the maths and put that together, that's over 2,000 hours of otolith preparation and ageing.
The age composition of the commercial catch is then used to inform stock assessment models in three important ways. It provides information on the numbers of young fish entering the fishery.
Some years they're weak year classes, some years they're really strong year classes, and they'll prop up a fishery potentially for 10 or 20 years. So it's really important for managers to understand whether we've got lots of good spawning years or maybe there's a number of not so good spawning years coming through. It helps us understand the growth of the fish and how that may change through time in response to changes in the fish population itself.
The other important way that the age structure of the commercial catch informs the model is it provides information on the ear selectivity.
This is trawl or precision seafood harvesting, but we may have another method like, say, long lining, and they interact with the fish population in a different way.
Smaller fish are often found on nursery grounds away from the fishing grounds, or they pass through the nets and larger fish can outswim the fishing gear. Once the model can take account of the recruitment strength and the selectivity, it's able to then calculate and determine the age structure of the population itself. We can then do projections for management based on alternative catch levels. You want to ensure conservation as well as utilization of the fish stock. Effective shed sampling programs, first of all, require a really good design, and then secondly, they require really good liaison with the fishing industry.
They're out there working and they care about what it is that they're catching. They work really hard and they know that without the science and it leads to the management, they wouldn't have anything to catch. So they're really cooperative with us when we work with them.